Hi, I'm Paul Wilson, creator of the Body Swing. Here's another tip to help you with your game. If you like this tip, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you'll be notified when I post new tips. In this tip, I want to use this head cover to illustrate lag. So everybody wants more lag. Lag. Okay, so what does the word lag mean? Lag means something is trailing behind something else. So this head cover perfectly illustrates it. So just understand, this stiff part of the head cover, that represents your golf club. This flexible part, that represents your arms. And my hand twirling it, that represents your body. So if I want to twirl this head cover, this part of the head cover needs to lag behind my hand. And it will do that if I start to twirl my hand. So we're going to try and do this in slow motion so you can see that my hand twirls first, then the head cover moves. All right, to get this airborne, or get it making a circle, I have to move my hand first. Then this is always lagging one step behind my hand. All right, so I'm going to start to twirl it like this. So all I'm doing, I'm spinning my hand. You can see that right here, my hand goes like that. In a circle, it makes the motion, then the head cover moves. Okay, so watch it again. So as I start to twirl that, I'm moving my hand, which gets the head cover twirling in midair. It just starts moving. Right. So what does that mean for our golf swing? Well, if we want lag in our golf swing, we need to move our body before we move the golf club. That means your club is trailing behind your body. So a lot of people out there, you know, they're working on lag by going like this and moving the golf club. And, you know, that can be fine because that at least gives you the feeling of what you're doing. And then I'd like you to release the club if that's something that you're working on. But you've got to understand what you're even trying to do to get the lag in your swing. So all you're doing is you're moving your body and letting your arms follow. All right, so if you're up here and you know you're trying to hit that golf ball as hard as you can, you keep moving the stiff part of the head cover before you're pulling your hand. So that means your body is lagging behind the golf club. That's why, you know, when people don't lag it, they get into a position where they're casting the golf club. They're moving their club before they're moving their body. And if you watch pros hit a golf ball, we start with our body facing the golf ball, and when we hit the ball, our body is rotated over here, you know, 40 odd degrees. You know, some players are even more than that. But if I start facing the ball and I hit it with my hips open, my body must be ahead of the golf club. Then you take a look at, you know, your average player, and they are basically just facing the ball when they hit the ball. So right here, your body is not ahead of the golf club. That's because you're moving the club, and you're just basically facing the ball at impact. So in no way is your body ahead of the golf club. So you will sit here forever trying to get lag, and it's never going to happen because you keep moving the mass before the axis. So start thinking a little bit differently. Start seeing it in your mind. Just do some swings up in the air. Imagine this is the stiff part of the head cover. This was the flexible part. Okay, so there's no power in your arms. This is you trying to twirl it. So you just sit here like this. Think body and the arms with the golf club are gonna follow. And yes, that takes a little coordination if you've never done it before. It's totally different. It's the opposite to what you've been doing for many, many years. So you've got to do that over and over and over again. So in your mind, just think about that twirling head cover. Just every night, just sit there and do practice swings. Body, then the club. Body, then the club. So if I do it this way, feel like your body is going to point that way, and the club is just hitting the ball. So I'm up here, body, club. Just keep doing it. Body, and then the club. I truly hope you've enjoyed this tip. You know, I've been teaching a powerful, effortless, pain-free golf swing now for over 25 years. If you'd like to learn this type of swing, then head on over to bodyswing.com/free samples. I'll send you some free samples of my book and video series that take you step by step by step through how to build a powerful, effortless, pain-free golf swing. So once again, head on over to bodyswing.com/free samples or click the link in or below this video, and I'll send you the free samples right away.